Welcome back to Sunrise. I'm live at Bondi Junction, and more on our top story and tributes are continuing this morning for security guard Faraz Tahir, who is one of the victims killed in the Bondi Junction tragedy. It's understood the 30-year-old was working his first daytime shift at the shopping centre when the attack happened. His death has sparked fresh calls for security guards to be better equipped to help keep the public and themselves safe. For more, we're joined by a friend of Faraz Tahir, Adnan Kadir. Good morning to you, Adnan. So sorry for your loss. What was your reaction to hearing the news of this tragedy?
Good morning, Matt. Thank you for your condolences and having me. It's a very tragic news. This is something which you don't expect at all. It's hard for me to fathom that he was with me 72 hours before this tragedy, and then we lost him in such circumstances.
Tell us about Faraz. What was he like?
Yeah, he was a great guy. He fled persecution from his home country in Pakistan, moved to Australia in December 22. He was big in terms of giving back to community. My initial interactions with him was through volunteer causes. Being a president of MDA Muslim Youth Association, we worked together on quite a few activities up there, be it Australia Cleanup Day, some activities around community, helping elderly. He was so big in terms of giving to everything he have to the wider community, and you could see some of those selfless act during this tragedy as well.
And it sounded like he was starting a beautiful new life here in Sydney, and that was tragically cut short. How will he be remembered?
He was a great guy. He keeps other people's interests ahead of him. Always happy to help, was really excited, have a lot of ambition for his future, just settling into his new country. As you've mentioned, it was his first day shift on that particular location. He was looking forward to a stable career, to make a family up here, and it's just sad how it all ended up.
Yeah, it's a horrific tragedy, isn't it? Adnan, thank you so much for your time and giving us a little bit of insight.
Thank you. Thanks, Matt.
Thank you, Shervo. Well, there are now calls for security guards at all shopping centres to be armed following the Bondi tragedy. Let's bring in Environment Minister Tanya Plibersek and Nationals MP Barnaby Joyce. Good morning to both of you. Tanya, we've just heard about Faraz, his first week on the job, I think his first daytime shift. What do you think about sending these people out with basically a water bottle to protect everyone?
Well, I think at the moment, Nat, we're all just reeling in shock and grieving. And I think there will be plenty of time to methodically go through what happened on the weekend and see if there are things that we can learn about how to make sure that people feel safe and are safe in places where they should be safe. At the moment, our focus is on the victims, their families, their friends, and all of the people who were there on the weekend, who I'm sure will be impacted probably for the rest of their lives by what's happened. A focus on what we can learn from this, absolutely we should do that in the future. There'll be plenty of time for that.
Yeah, you're right. And there's the police investigation. There will be many investigations into how on earth this happened. Right now, people are going to shopping centres and a lot of people feel unsafe. That's why I guess these questions are starting to be asked. Barnaby, pepper spray, batons, handcuffs, tasers, should they be carried by security guards? What's your opinion?
Well, I'm with Tanya on this one. We've got a lot of time to analyse exactly what we need to do, and if proper further actions need to be taken so that security guards are more secure, and more importantly, that the people they protect are more secure, then I'm sure that'll be a recommendation. But it's such a tragedy, isn't it? I mean, there's just no reason. If there was an actual reason, I suppose we'd have something to dislike, to hate, to be honest. But we have a person who's a diagnosed schizophrenic, estranged from their family, and even their family are apologising to others, saying, look, we are so sorry for what happened here. And those families, the grief that they're going through, and stabbing a child, stabbing women, I mean, it's just the whole thing's horrific. And that's why I think the nation as one is overwhelmingly shocked, and we even hear from Faraz Tahir's colleagues, friends, that whichever way you look at it, it's a disgusting event which showed the noblest intents of some people, the absolute tragedy of so many families, and the circumstances of mental illness and the dark, dark side of it.
Yeah, you're right, Tanya. There are so many tragic sides to this. And as Barnaby said, that statement from the attacker's parents too, at first feeling for Amy Scott, who had to pull that trigger. There are just so many sides to this, aren't there?
Yeah, I mean, it would be horrifying to think of. It's just awful. There is just for everybody involved, for the victims, for their families, for everybody who was there at Bondi Junction, for all the people who think I could have been there. I would have normally been there on a Saturday, and then for the family of the attacker to come out in this way, I just think it shows they've probably had a lifetime of pain and worry for their son, and to see something like this, and to be, saying to Amy Scott, "We don't blame you." It's incredibly sad.
Yeah, you're right. We'll leave it there. We thank you. We'll see you next week.